Hi, my name is Kimber Elayne Sprawl. I play Marianne in Girl from the North Country, and this is my Broadway bucket list. So my first dream role is Angelica Schuyler, because she's so strong, and that inner conflict that she has with this like cosmic love story tangled with her duty to be loyal to her family has always been intriguing to me. And quite like when I did The Lion King, I just felt really honored to be a part of like such a big legacy. Lion King has become so iconic that you feel pride when you like finally get to join the cast. And I feel the same way about Hamilton. It would just be really cool to be in the room where it happens.
So this is what it feels like to match wits with someone at your level. What the hell is the catch? It's the feeling of freedom of seeing the light. It's been frunking with the can and kite. You see it, right? The conversation lasted 2 minutes, maybe 3 minutes. Everything we said in total agreement. It's a dream and it's a bit of a dance. A bit of a posture, it's a bit of a scans. He's a bit of a flirt, but I'm gonna give it a chance. I asked about his family. Did you see his answer? His hands started fidgeting. He looked askance. He's penniless, just lying by the seat of his pants. Handsome boy doesn't know it. Peach fuzz and he can't even grow it. I want to take him far away from this place. And I turn to see my sister's face and she is... And I know she is, and her eyes are just. Then I realize three fundamental truths at the exact same time. I know my sister like I know my own mind. You will never find anyone as trusting or as kind. If I tell him that I love him, she'd be silently resigned. He'd be mine. She would say I'm fine. She'd be lying. But when I fantasize at night, it's Alexander's eyes as I romanticize what might have been if I hadn't sized him up so quickly. At least I keep his eyes in my life. To your union and the hope that you provide. She'll be happy as his bride. And I know he will never be satisfied. I will never be satisfied.
When I first heard Hadestown, I just fell in love. I love the music, especially Flowers. I feel like it's floral poetry. And Eurydice is so strong, and she has this beautiful sense of adventure and wonder, and she's so courageous and floaty. She has a light spirit, and I think it would be fulfilling if I ever were to take on that role and discover her journey even further.
Was to fall asleep, close my eyes and disappear like a petal on the stream, a feather on the air. Lily white and poppy red, I trembled when he laid me out. You won't feel thing he said when you go down. Nothing gonna wake you now. Dreams are sweet until they're not. Men are kind until they aren't. Flowers bloom until they rot and fall apart. Is anybody listening? I open my mouth and nothing comes out. Nothing, nothing gonna wake me. Now, fly. walking in the sun. I remember someone, someone by my side, turned his face to mine, and then I turned away into the shade. You, the one I left behind, if you ever walk this way, come and find me lying in the bed I've made.
When I first discovered Audra McDonald was when I discovered Your Daddy's Son from Ragtime. That was in about the 10th grade. And ever since, I've just wanted to play the role of Sarah. That came at such a pivotal moment in my life because I was in such a place of inadequacy. I felt like I didn't have the voice that people expected me to have. And there just wasn't a lot of material for Black girls. I mean, we've come away, but there still just was this stereotype, and I felt like if I didn't succumb to that stereotype, then I wasn't successful. Learning this song and learning who Audra was and all of her glory, her ability to tell a story, and she was just authentically herself, and she sang like this beautiful songbird, it encouraged me to just be myself. I felt seen. I felt seen and I felt represented.
Daddy never knew that you were on your way. He had other ladies and other tunes to play. When he up and left me, I just up and run. Only thing in my head, you were your daddy's son. No music, couldn't see no light. Mama, she was frightened, crazy from the fright. Tears without no comfort, screaming.